Welcome to the Isle of Knowledge. Traveling is something we all inherited from our genes. We have lived as nomadic hunter-gatherers, moving about in small bands of 150 or fewer people. Although we have evolved over the period, that innate desire to wander the lands is still embedded deeply in our psyche. In today's video, we are taking you to the moon, possibly our next home. On 11th of December 2022, NASA's Orion spacecraft splashed down in the Pacific Ocean, west of California after a record-breaking mission. Orion traveled more than 2.25 million kilometers on a path around the moon and returned safely to Earth, completing the Artemis 1 flight test. Splashdown is the final milestone of the Artemis 1 mission that began with a successful liftoff of NASA's Space Launch System rocket on 16th of November 2022 from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Over the course of 26 days, NASA tested Orion in the harsh environment of deep space near the Moon. On its journey, Orion zoomed to the Moon, and then entered a wide swooping orbit, for nearly a week before coming back home. It came within 130 kilometers of the Moon twice, and at its farthest, it was more than 430,000 kilometers from Earth. After the success of Operation Artemis 1, NASA expects to launch Operation Artemis 2, which will take astronauts around the Moon. The Artemis 3 mission is expected to mark humanity's return to Earth's only natural satellite, sometime between 2024 and 2025. Since Yuri Gagarin became the first human to leave Earth in 1961, over 500 brave adventurers have made the journey into space. Today, astronauts and cosmonauts from around the world visit the International Space Station, which serves as a microgravity research laboratory for them. Although life on the International Space Station is far from easy, those challenges are not strong enough to stop space travelers' willpower. Living in space is a risky affair. Aside from the threats from space debris and malfunctioning technology, high levels of radiation and temperature extremes can present dangers to space explorers. Meanwhile, lack of gravity can cause physiological and psychological issues for people who live in space for a longer period. Therefore, humans are not able to live in space permanently. In space, humans are dependent on spacecraft or space stations for life support, such as air, water, heating, and food. These resources must be brought from Earth or produced on site, which is difficult and often very expensive. Therefore, living in space is currently only possible through human spaceflight missions, which are limited in duration and scope. However, there are plans for long-term human habitation on lunar bases and Mars colonies. These plans involve the development of sustainable life support systems, radiation protection, and methods for growing foods and other essentials in a closed environment. You must be wondering what makes the Moon so special. There are plenty of reasons to consider the Moon as our next home. Living on the Moon is considered less challenging than living in other parts of the solar system, such as Mars, for several reasons. The Moon is only 384,000 kilometers away from Earth and has lower gravity, which would make it easier to launch and land spacecraft. Additionally, the Moon's day-night cycle is similar to that on Earth in some ways, but also very different. Like Earth, the Moon rotates on its axis and has a day and night cycle, with one lunar day lasting about 29.5 Earth days. This is because the Moon takes about 29.5 Earth days to complete one rotation on its axis, which is about the same amount of time it takes to orbit the Earth once. The next reason is that the Moon has similarities to the composition of elements, which means that it has many of the same resources that we have on Earth. The majority of the minerals that make up the Earth and the Moon are silicates, which are composed of silicon and oxygen. Both have small amounts of volatile elements, such as hydrogen, helium, and neon. Additionally, the Moon contains trace amounts of rare Earth elements like dysprosium and europium. There is hope for making oxygen on the Moon. The soil on the Moon, called regolith, does not contain oxygen. The regolith is made mostly of silicon, aluminum, calcium, and iron, and does not have the organic compounds that are necessary for the production of oxygen. However, regolith typically contains around 40 to 45% oxygen by weight, in the form of silicon dioxide, which is the main compound of lunar soil. Additionally, scientists have proposed plans to extract oxygen from lunar soil through a process called regolith electrolysis. Oxygen can be harvested by robots, and NASA has already developed and field-tested prototype robots capable of fulfilling this role. If you are thinking about water, here it is. Water ice has been discovered on the Moon in 2009. NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter and the Indian Space Research Organization's Chandrayaan 1 mission both detected evidence of water ice at the Moon's poles, in the form of hydrogen and ice molecules. This ice is thought to be located in permanently shadowed craters, near the poles, where the temperature never gets warm enough for the ice to sublimate. In 2018, the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter's neutron detector instrument provided direct evidence of hydrogen, a signature of water, on the surface of the Moon. This water ice is found in the coldest and darkest parts of the Moon, primarily at the poles and in deep craters near the poles. However, the amount of water ice on the Moon is thought to be relatively small, and it is not yet known if it is easily accessible, or if it would be possible to extract it for use by humans. By the way, the presence of water ice on the Moon is significant, because it could potentially be used as a resource for future lunar exploration, such as drinking water and rocket fuel. The discovery of water ice on the Moon also has implications for the possibility of finding water elsewhere in the solar system, and the potential for supporting life. Energy is essential for human survival on the Moon. Luckily, the lunar soil contains almost all the materials needed to build solar panels. Solar panels are made up of silicon, which is the most abundant element in the lunar regolith, and can be extracted from it. The regolith also contains small amounts of other elements like aluminum, iron, and titanium, that could be used in the manufacturing of solar panels. Scientists have also found evidence of other resources, such as helium-3, which could be used as a fuel for nuclear fusion. The next most important question is about food. Can plants grow on the Moon? The Moon's soil is dusty and very fine sand, which would rapidly erode away from a plant's roots. In addition, it also contains lots of toxic metals and other compounds harmful to plant growth. But scientists and engineers are currently researching the possibility of growing plants on the Moon. NASA has been working to create closed-loop life support systems that might be able to support the growth of plants on the Moon. These systems use airtight containers to maintain a suitable atmosphere for plants, and use water and nutrient recycling to sustain plant growth. In addition, there have been some experimental projects such as the Chinese Lunar Palace 365 project, which sought to determine whether it would be possible to grow plants on the Moon, in a sealed, closed-loop system. It is worth mentioning that, growing plants in a moon base or lunar colony would be important for the long-term habitation of the Moon, as plants can be used for food, oxygen production, and waste recycling. They could also be used to purify the air, remove carbon dioxide, and even provide a psychological benefit to the inhabitants. But it is easier said than done. To establish a long-term human presence on the Moon, a number of obstacles would need to be overcome. The lunar environment is extremely harsh, and not conducive to human life. It has very high levels of radiation. Additionally, the temperature on the lunar surface can vary greatly between day and night, with daytime temperatures reaching up to 127 degrees Celsius, and nighttime temperatures dropping to minus 173 degrees Celsius. The other problem is the lack of resources. The Moon has no atmosphere, no water, and no magnetic field, and its soil is not rich in nutrients and minerals, which makes it difficult to sustain human life and build self-sufficient colonies. The other challenge is launching people and materials to the Moon. It is a very challenging task. Even though we are talking about inhabiting the Moon, the technology is not yet ready. There are many technical challenges that have yet to be overcome in order to build a sustainable habitat on the Moon, such as developing life support systems, radiation shielding, and structures that can withstand the extreme temperatures and micrometeoroids. When it comes to safety, the harsh lunar environment would pose a significant risk to human health, and the lack of a protective atmosphere would expose inhabitants to dangerous levels of radiation. Living on the Moon in isolation would be a daunting task. It would take several days to travel back and forth from Earth, and communication would be heavily delayed. On the other hand, establishing a permanent human presence on the Moon would be incredibly expensive, and require significant investments in technology and infrastructure. The Moon may be a harsh and barren place, but it holds the key to our future, as a spacefaring species. With the right technology and resources, we can turn the Moon into a thriving home, and a gateway to the rest of the solar system. If we talk about the future, we need to set a point, and the Moon would be a splendid place to start. Despite all of these challenges, NASA and other space agencies are optimistic about the establishment of a lunar base, as a stepping stone to long-term human exploration of the solar system. Private companies have also shown an interest in exploring the Moon since they can get their share of glory, as well as a more interesting side of the business for them and their customers. Ethics have to be taken into consideration as well, as we shouldn't risk too many lives, or start any major conflicts in trying to reach the Moon. Hence, there has been a lot of controversy regarding whether or not this adventure serves a better purpose for humanity. But that's up to you to decide. What do you think about migrating to the Moon? Do you think it will be a better leap for humanity? Share your comments below. Until see you in another video, we wish you a glorious day. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.